And we're coming to you from Hohokam Stadium in Mesa, Arizona, as we welcome you in to the 28th annual MSBL World Series, where tonight the Sacramento Bulldogs will be taking on the Holland Astros. And my name is Jeff Lowery with APMvideo.com. Glad you could join us here. There's a threat of rain here tonight, though the weatherman says that for the most part, only light sprinkles. As you get a look now at Montiano Bloom, the manager on the left of the Holland Astros. He had lived in the Houston area for 5 years from 2006 to 2010 and had the dream of building a team that he could bring out here year after year. And after playing a couple of seasons with different management, he started his own team and they became the Holland Astros. It's a mix of American and also players from Europe. The Bulldogs on the other side are coming in here with a record of no wins and three losses and hoping to turn things around. It's a must-win situation for both these teams. Manny Ocampo will lead the charge. He's the third place hitter in the lineup here today. And when we come back, we'll have the first pitch and all the exciting play-by-play action coming to you from Hohokam Stadium in Mesa. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN. Well, you can see the clouds hovering above Hohokam Stadium here in Mesa, Arizona, as Danny Rossoni gets set to take his final warm-up tosses, a hard-throwing right-hander. Rossoni is out of Italy, Bergamo, Italy, spent a couple of years, lived a couple of years in England, age 50, hard-throwing right-hander. He'll be facing Fred Fenton, Tim Rooney, and Sean Rooney to start things off. It's Sacramento and Holland, and the first pitch of the contest is taken low for ball one, and this game is underway. Our game time temperature, 77 degrees, a little humid. You got a chance of scattered rain showers, most likely just sprinkles in this game as this one's grounded towards the shortstop. This will be a tough play. Quick throw on to first in time for out number one. So Greg Bertram over to Dan Clemens for the first out. Clemens at first, Coleman at second, Bertram at short. Swart out is at third base. And here's a bunt. Third base side, and the catcher cannot make the play. Well, a nice effort there by Peter Ralbus. And a second opportunity for the center fielder, Tim Rooney. One out, nobody on here in the first, and it's quickly nothing in two. A good breaking ball that time by Danny Rossoni. Second place hitter up there for the Sacramento Bulldogs, who come in here with a record of 0-3. That's popped up, first base side, catcher, and Ralbus on the warning track in front of the first base dugout hauls it in for out number two. That'll bring up the third place hitter and shortstop, Sean Rooney. We began to touch on it in our pregame. We're in the Cactus 45 and over division. Of course, these two teams through three games of round-robin play, and obviously both teams will be playing six games in round-robin play when it's all said and done. This makes this game extremely pivotal. And a victory here today for either team puts them back in the hunt for a playoff, even the 0-3 Bulldogs, which a lot of people are very surprised that this team is off to an 0-3 start. This is a very talented team. And they're hoping to turn things around. They got Dave Blackburn, who won a national championship last year, going on the mound when the Holland Astros come out in the bottom of the first. Here's a looper back of shortstop. Bertram is out and makes the over-the-shoulder catch to retire the side. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on after a half an inning of play. It's Sacramento nothing. And the Holland Astros coming up. You're getting a look at veteran MSBL World Series competitor Dave Blackburn. He was on that 55 and over championship team that won last year in the South Bay Zephyrs, a guy that can play many positions on the field. And he'll be facing Ott von der Londen to start things off, Harry DeVutt and Manny Ocampo. First pitch of the Home half of inning number one is taken high for ball one. That's a strike. One ball and one strike. Odd out of Rotterdam, 51 years young. Started playing baseball in 1981 and has played fast pitch softball, as many of these Holland Astro players have. And he's the leadoff hitter to start things off. Bottom half of the first inning. Sacramento went down in order in the top of the first inning. That one is lifted in the air, but it's out of play. The right-hander winds, kicks, and delivers. That's high, 2-2. He's played baseball with Montiano Bloom and some of the other players from the Holland Astros a couple of years ago after Montiano had, of course, lived. Montiano, the manager of this Holland team, lived in Houston for 5 years and had played in the World Series a couple of times. And then a couple of years ago, he came up with the idea with the Dutch team in the World Series, as this one is lifted over the shortstop's head and out into left field. And Van der Linden is in with a base hit to start things off. Good start here for the Astros in the home half of the first inning. The batter is going to be Harry DeVitt.
Harry DeVitt.
Finishing that story, though, after coming up with the idea to have a Dutch team at the World Series, unfortunately he didn't find enough players, did Montiano Bloom, in the 45 and over to form a Dutch team, so he formed a mixed team with Dutch and U.S. players, and that's kind of how this whole thing got going. So Harry up there with a runner at first and nobody out. We're in the home half of inning number one. Harry, who is a longtime friend of Montiano, as the runner started to go and then held up and it's fouled off. Really had no choice but to be a part of this Houston Astro or Holland Astros team. Plays fast pitch softball. Ground ball down to third. They'll go second one. They'll try to turn the double play, but the relay is not in time, and Harry DeVitt is on with a fielder's choice, 5-4. Now out of Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Manny Ocampo, another longtime member of the MSBL World Series, formerly of the Las Vegas Rattlers. That first pitch is taken outside for ball one. Runner at first base with one out. We're in the home half of the first inning in this 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN. Jeff Lowery with you on the play-by-play action. Right-hander sights a sign. Manny Ocampo with a close stance. And he takes outside on a breaking pitch. Manny, when going well, he can hit to all fields. His team has been featured on our broadcast many a times down through the years, and always one of the pleasures in covering any game that Manny is set up. That's taken for a strike. That one looked a little under the knees, but a good pitch by Blackburn. Blackburn versus Ocampo here in the home half of the first inning. Scoreless tie and a runner at first base. From the winter home of the Oakland Athletics, Hohokam Stadium. And a check swing foul. Two strikes on Ocampo. Blackburn delivers. And this one, kind of a half swing. Roller to the second baseman. They'll go second one. No chance for two. Good hustle by Manny down the first baseline. So a pair of fielder's choice here in the home half of the first inning. Now two down, Manny at first base, and here's the manager of the Holland Astros, Montiano Bloom. First pitch, a called strike, and it's 0-1. Now, Montiano spells his last name B-L-O-M, but he puts the extra O in there because it's pronounced like the actor Bloom. And that way, no one gets confused. That is swung on and fouled straight back, and Montiano had a tremendous cut at that last pitch. This is a great matchup here. The cleanup hitter for Holland against Dave Blackburn. And a changeup, and Montiano stayed back and was able to foul off that tough pitch. Two strikes on the Holland cleanup hitter and dealing. And a check swing foul, so he stays alive. Scott Scardina doing the catching here today for the Sacramento Bulldogs. A must-win situation for both teams. Holland coming in with a record of 1-2. The Bulldogs looking for their first win in this, their fourth game of round-robin play. This ball is hammered down the left field line. Fair ball, base hit. Manny Ocampo will hold up at second. The second hit of the ball game and the second hit in this first inning for the Holland Astros. And they're cooking here in the home half of the first inning. And Marvin Keller will be the batter. Tough left-handed hitter. First pitch is taken low and inside, ball one. Marvin playing in his third year with the Holland Astros, the 10th year playing in the MSBL World Series. Bats left, throws left. That's a strike and it's 1-1. Been playing baseball most of his life. Played competitively at high school and at college at Texas A&M. Here's a shot caught by the shortstop. A sensational play by Sean Rooney. And at the end of one, no score from Hohokam. The 28th annual MSBL World Series will continue in just a moment. No score as we head now to inning number two. Second inning of work for starting pitcher Danny Rossoni. And he'll be facing the heart of the Sacramento lineup in Joe Hoy, Scott Brown, and John Heredia. Good fastball, swung through and missed, and it's nothing in one on the cleanup hitter and third baseman for Sacramento. Scott Scardina is the manager of the Sacramento Bulldogs. He is assisted by Robert Sexton. So Joe Hoy starting things off here in the top of the second inning. No score. Sacramento went down in order in the first inning. And another opportunity for Bertram as he moves to his left and fires on to first base. Nice play by Dan Clemens, and there's one down. Next up is going to be Scott Brown, the left fielder. Swing and a miss. Nothing in one on the fifth place hitter. Danny Rossoni. He's been playing in club baseball for some 25 years. And from what they told us, he's played in and around the continent of Europe. And of course, Montiano emailed him in September. This is the first trip to the United States ever for Danny. And his first World Series appearance, obviously. Says his favorite players were Kirk Gibson, Pedro Martinez, Ken Griffey, and Dennis Eckersley. No score, top of the second. Scott Brown at the plate taking a breaking ball way inside. Rossoni has faced the minimum so far with this, the fifth hitter in the lineup for Sacramento. Two balls, two strikes. Danny looks in for the sign, kicks and deals. And he left that one high, and it's full. Full count, three balls, two strikes. John Heredia taking his phantom swings in the on-deck circle. Hopes to bat with somebody on base here, and that would be having to be Scott Brown, the 3-2 pitch. And he struck him out swinging, his first strikeout of the game for Danny, and there's one down. Good fastball, came back with the high heat. Two down in the inning, and John Heredia, the right fielder. Fastball at the knees, a called strike. He's got good movement on that pitch. That might most likely was a four-seam fastball. Nothing and one the count on John Heredia. Top of the second inning, no score. Sacramento at the plate in the red tops, the white pants. That's high, and it's one ball, one strike. Sixth place hitter in the lineup. Holland's only victory in the tournament came yesterday, 18-1 at the hands of Kendall. They come in with a record of one win and two losses. We mentioned that Sacramento is 0-3, so a very pivotal game for both these teams. A victory could put both teams back in the playoff hunt. That swung on and fouled back, and it's 1-2. Holland playing their fourth game through their first 2 days of the 45 and over Cactus Division round robin. A swing and a miss, a slider biting down and away, and down goes John Heredia, and down goes the Bulldogs in the top of the second. We go to the home half, still no score from Hohokam Park. We're in Mesa, Arizona. And you're watching the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN Video Sports. Well, the Holland Astros donning the uniforms of the Houston Astros. Well, here's Swartow batting for the first time, swinging and fouling one off. Marcel Mar Swartow. Out of Rotterdam, driving one to right field, and the catch is made for out number one. The batter's going to be shortstop Greg Bertram, 57-year-old father of three, married 34 years, began playing adult baseball at age 41. He's a mechanical engineer. First pitch is high for ball one. No score, bottom half of inning number two here from Hohokam Stadium in Mesa. Making his eighth trip to the Phoenix World Series, enjoys classic car restoration and fly fishing. That's out of play. A ball and a strike to the Holland Astros shortstop. A swing and a miss at a hard slider by Blackburn, and it's one ball and two strikes. One out, nobody on. We're in inning number two here, home half of inning number two. 45 and over Cactus Division. Here's a chopper out in front of the plate. Blackburn, who fields his position well, throws on to first, two down. So the next batter is going to be Dan Clemens. Dan, the starting first baseman. Dan is in his second year with the Holland Astros. Dan is also the author of AA Perfect Season book cover, Perfect Season, A Coach's Journey to Learning, Competing, and Having Fun in Youth Baseball. Says he's climbed 50 of the 54 mountain peaks in Colorado. And he rifles one out in the center field. Long run and a nice attempt by the center fielder to no avail. And a big turn for Clemens as he heads back to first base. So a two-out single keeps inning number two alive for the Holland Astros in this scoreless tie. That's going to bring up Brian Benko, better known as Scrappy. He's a groundskeeper by trade. And Benko bats with two out and a runner at first base here in the second. First pitch, called strike, quick throw down to first, and back in easily is Dan Clemens, who's got good speed down there. Got to be in phenomenal shape to be, if you can climb 50 of the 54 Colorado, or what do they say, the peaks in Colorado, 14,000 feet. As they throw him out at first base, fine play by the third baseman, that's Joe Hoy, And the second inning is in the book. So we are heading to the third. Sacramento and Holland hooking up in a pitcher's duel. No score. As we go to the top of the third inning, Jeff Lowery with you, APM Video Sports. A special thanks to both teams. I'd like to welcome all of you coming, watching our broadcast in Sacramento, California, in that area, Northern California. As Rossoni will start inning number three, the starting pitcher here today for the Holland Astros. And the first offering to Eric Sex, the first baseman, is ball one. A strike called evens the count at one ball and one strike. The 7-8-9 hitters, Eric Sex, the first baseman, starting pitcher Dave Blackburn, and the catcher and manager of Sacramento is Scott Scardina, batting in the number 9 position. Here's a chopper on a couple of hots to the charging Coleman, and he'll throw him out at first base, one down. So 7 up and 7 down, retired by Rossoni. And a breaking pitch to Dave Blackburn, catches the inside corner, strike one. Good pitch. We mentioned that Dave was on that 55 and over Cactus Division National Championship South Bay Zephyrs as he skies one out into deep center field, and it's over the head of Harry DeVitt. Blackburn, as that ball rolls all the way to the fence, is heading towards third, and he's got a one-out triple, and he represents the first run of the ball game. So a long, long triple to center field by Dave Blackburn. He put a charge into that one. Here's Scott Scardina. Popped him up, fouling out of play, and it's 0-1. Well, right now, if you're the defense, I think you may give up this run to get that out. As the bounces one down to third, probably the last play, Scardina won to hit it. The throw on to first is in time. Fine play by Swart out at third base. And they hold the runner at third, and there's two down, and here's Dean Mann. Tenth and final hitter in the lineup, and he comes through with a big two-out single to left field. And Sacramento draws first blood, and they lead it here in the top of the third, 1-0 on the RBI single by Dean Mann. Eric Sachs will be the courtesy runner at first base. And we go back to the top of the order in Fred Fenton. Not sure what this discussion is about. Usually in these situations when you see both, well, I think what Montiano Bloom was stating is that the last batted out was Scott Scardina, as the first pitch is in there for ball one. It's usually the last batted out is the courtesy runner. And that's why they had Eric Sex come out. So Montiano Bloom doing some heads-up managing over there in that first base dugout. Nice play by the catcher. Keeping that ball in front of him as Ralbus. And the runner taking off for second. Good throw down to second, but it's not in time. And Scott Scardina has a stolen base. So Sacramento has another runner in scoring position here in the third. They lead it 1-0 on an RBI hit by Dean Mann. And that's ball four. So first and second occupied with two out. And here's the center fielder, Tim Rooney. Sacramento at the plate leading it 1-0, top half of inning number three. Rossoni delivers high at ball one. Danny Rossoni on the mound out of Bergamo, Italy. He has struck out two. He has walked one. He has given up two hits and one earned run. And here's a shot out into left center field. Long run, sliding attempt, and the ball is in. Another run is going to score, and the quick throw to third, not in time. And heading down to second is going to be Tim Rooney with a double. Another RBI hit. Runners are at second and third as Fenton needs a courtesy runner. And it's 2-0 Sacramento here in the top of the third as the Holland Astros now try to regroup and set their sights on third place hitter and shortstop Sean Rooney. Rooney popped up to the shortstop back in a perfect first inning for Rossoni. He hits one softly to the shortstop. He'll field on the big hop and throw on to first base to retire the side. So Bertram on over to Clemens. A very eventful inning. Sacramento scores two. We head to the home half of the third. Sacramento 2, the Holland Astros nothing. The 28th annual MSBL World Series on APM Video. Brought to you by
66, Titus Lumber.
Brought to you by our play-by-play videos. Don't forget to give us a call early next year and reserve your next MSBL World Series game at apnvideo.com. Titus Bloom will start it off, the younger brother of Montiano Bloom, the manager of this Hollins Astro team. Here's a shot by Titus out in the right field, and it's going to be caught. Nice one-handed grab by Heredia in right field for the first out. So we go back to the top of the order, and Odd Vanderlanden tried to check his swing, could not. Bottom half of the third inning, Sacramento putting two runs up on the board in the top of this inning, and they lead it 2-0. Vanderlanden with a base hit back in the first, takes a curveball, kind of ducking out of the way of that one, telling you just how much of a break Dave Blackburn's breaking ball had. You saw Vanderlanden kind of bailing out, and now down nothing and two, and he comes back with a pitch way outside. Tried to get him fishing, and it's 1-2. Out of Rotterdam, started playing baseball in 1981. And that's strike three called to a guy that plays a lot of fast pitch softball over in Rotterdam. So there is two down here in the Holland third inning. And excuse me if I've called Holland Astros Houston Astros. That's just 40 plus years of being a baseball fan and following the Houston Astros as Harry DeVitt bounces one back to Blackburn, and the third inning is in the books. We are heading to the top of the fourth, and Sacramento leads Holland 2-0 from Hohokam Park. It's the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN. Third baseman Joe Hoy will start it off. We go to the top of the fourth inning, Hoy, Brown, and Heredia. Sacramento looking for their first win in the 2015 MSBL World Series. Nothing and one on the Sacramento third baseman. But as we said at the top of the broadcast, a victory here today that puts them at 1-3 many times in these bigger divisions. As that one's outside, 1-1 on Joe Hoy, who's 0-1, grounded to shortstop back in the second. Sometimes you can get in with two wins. You can go 2-4 and make the playoffs. And Sacramento's got the talent to get this thing all the way back to a 3-3 record. 2-1. Rossoni was wondering where that last pitch was. Was hoping to get a called strike. Here's a chopper to the right side, and the throw on to first by Sean Vondershawn Coleman is in time for out number one. That'll bring up Scott Brown, who is one of two strikeout victims of Rossoni in this ball game, and that breaking ball. He has done a good job of getting that first pitch breaking ball over, which obviously will add feet to his fastball, and he's ahead of the count on the Sacramento left fielder at 0-1. Coleman, who gets the start at second base, born in Frankfurt, Germany. Played with the Houston team for many years. That's upstairs, 1-1, Scott Brown with Heredia, the right fielder on deck. Sacramento got two runs In the third inning, they got RBI hits from Dean Mann and center fielder Tim Rooney. In the air, slicing towards the first baseman, and in foul territory, Clemens makes the catch, two down. So a ground ball to second, a pop-up to the first baseman, and with two out and nobody on, here's John Heredia. Breaking pitch, just inside, ball one. Sony has had a lot of success in getting that pitch, that breaking pitch, over for a called strike, and he didn't miss by much on that first offering. Heredia struck out back in the second inning. 2-0 Sacramento as they bat here in the top of the fourth. And an inside-out swing has popped up, but this one's going to land up off the top of the dugout and out of play. One ball, one strike on Heredia. Outside 2-1. Let's see if Heredia tries to go to right field again on this pitch. And the fastball ate him up. He fouled that one off. Did a good job of fouling off a tough fastball that was kind of up and in. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. And he gets muscled this time. And a ball hit to the first baseman. Dan's got it over to the covering pitcher. And that is that. We're heading to the bottom half of inning number four. Sacramento leading the Holland Astros by a score of 2-0.
Manny Ocampo.
Manny Ocampo will start things off. Manny hit into a fielder's choice back in the first. He's 0-1. Holland at the plate, trailing in the bottom of the fourth inning, 2-0. He swings and lines one out into left field, a base hit. So Manny Ocampo with the fourth hit of the day for the Holland Astros. So he is aboard to start things off, and now the manager of the Holland Astros, Montiano Bloom. Montiano lived in Houston from 2006 to 2010. And he rifles one up the middle for a base hit. Started this team in 2013 with both Dutch and American friends. And really does a lot of work. A lot of the players wanted to say that the work that he does allows them to kind of just concentrate on the game of baseball. Here's a bunt up along the first baseline. Marvin Keller batting for the second time. Playing in his third year with the Holland Astros, his 10th in the MSBL World Series. Played competitively in high school and at college with Texas A&M. Enjoys woodworking, man of faith. As this ball gets away, here's Manny coming down to third without a throw, and they're at second and third, and both the tying runs are in scoring position. So Marvin Keller says that he chose the number 33 because that was the age that Jesus had died for his salvation and of all those who believe. And he says his most dedicated fan is Mary, wife of 26. As we mentioned, his 10th MSBL World Series. Marvin Keller at the plate with second and third occupied. Nobody out, and he swings and lines it into right field. One run will score. That's Manny Ocampo. Here comes Monty to the plate. Here comes a throw. It's cut off. It's tied. Two runs single to right field by Marvin Keller, and the Holland Astros are even with Sacramento here in the bottom of the fourth.
Number 28.
So a two-run single by Marvin Keller, the fifth-place hitter, and Elmar Suardo. Young, married to his wife Karen, and popping up to the first baseman, and an easy play for Eric Sex, and that is the first out of the inning. Now the shortstop, Greg Bertram, goes after the first pitch. Blackburn bobbles it, third base side of the mound, and all hands are going to be safe. Well, it's going to be interesting if they call that an infield hit or an error. And it looks like they've said that's going to be an error on the pitcher. Now Dan Clemens, the second baseman. It's beginning to sprinkle a little bit. Left-handed hitter had a base hit back in the second. Swing and a miss. So Holland with six hits in the ball game here in the bottom half of the fourth inning. Sacramento two runs on three hits. One error in the ball game just committed by Blackburn. That's upstairs for a ball. That's amazing. Dan Clemens has climbed, I'm going to say it again, 50 of the 54 mountain peaks in Colorado above 14,000 feet. He's also completed four marathons. Lives in Colorado with his wife and two children. And he's up there with an opportunity to give his team the lead. Runners are at first and second with only one out. We're in the home half of inning number four. The Holland Astros and the Sacramento Bulldogs battling here in the 45 and over Cactus Division of the 2015 MSBL World Series. Chopper to the left side. Third baseman will beat the runner to the bag as he had to dive with the baseball in his hand. That'll be a fielder's choice, going five unassisted. Runners remain at first and second, but now two out for Scrappy Benko. Benko grounded out to third back in the second inning. We're in the bottom of the fourth, a 2-2 tie. Holland trying to push across the go-ahead run, who stands out there at second base. Here's the pitch. That's upstairs. And one ball, one strike on Benko. Actually, it's three balls and no strikes. This is Brian's first World Series, and obviously the first year with the Holland Astros. Three balls, one strike, a groundskeeper. He says there's nothing like that he likes more than playing this great game and being behind the plate. Played on Rick Fisher's team in Denver. And here's a swing and a miss, and now they're going to say a foul ball. He just got a piece of it. So the count goes three balls, two strikes, two out, two on, and a 2-2 tie here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Almost has a Paul Molitor-like batting stance up there. Let's see if he can come through as he fouls it off. That was a tough pitch. Blackburn kind of took a little bit off that pitch and left that one up. He was lucky that it was up and in, as Blackburn now fakes a throw back to second base. Greg Bertram, courtesy running, is at second base here for Holland. Three balls, two strikes. Runners will be going, and here's the pitch. And ball four, and the bases are loaded. What an at-bat by Scrappy Benko. That is the first walk of the day issued by Blackburn, and now Titus Bloom, the scheduled hitter. Titus, who plays more fast pitch softball than he does baseball, 50 years young. He's been on a Dutch national championship team in fast pitch softball back in the Dutchlands. Could not resist that hard-biting slider and swung right over the top of it. He's got the bases loaded. Go ahead, run at third base and a 2-2 tie. And did he check his swing that time? Blackburn wanting the appeal. Of course, the second base umpire is not in a position to make that call, but unfortunately, we only have two umpires for this game. And a check swing comebacker, Blackburn to first. He pitches out of the inning. It could have been a lot worse as we head to the top of the fifth inning. Holland scores two to equalize. Top of the fifth coming up from Hohokam.
Number eight, Eric Sex.
Eric Sext to start things off. Seventh place hitter in the lineup for Sacramento. He is 0 for 1. Grounded out second to first back in inning number 3 as we head to the top of the fifth inning from Hohokam in a 2-2 tie in the 45 and over Cactus Division. Both teams playing in their fourth round robin game. Both these teams have played four games through their first 2 days. I guess the good thing is the next 2 days you have single games and get a little rest. This is obviously a very important game for both teams. We talked about the playoff implications. But I think more importantly here, both managers need a lot of innings out of these two starting pitchers. There's a slider that is swung over and missed, and the third strikeout for Rossoni. He has scattered three hits through the first four and a third inning. And now Dave Blackburn, who scored the game's first run after hitting a long, long triple to center field back in the third. Danny delivers a knee-high fastball called strike, and it's 0-1. Rossoni has struck out three. He has walked one. He has scattered three hits, two runs, both earned. We're in the top of the fifth in a 2-2 tie. Sacramento in the red tops. Batting. Good pitch, but it was a little off the plate. And it's 1-1. So Blackburn up there, 1-for-1 with a triple and a run scored. And that one is a little low. Two balls, one strike. Good pitching matchup, Dave Blackburn and Danny Rossoni out of Bergamo, Italy. That one is high and tight, and it's 3-1. You can tell that Danny is really pitching somewhat defensive here because of the way Blackburn drove the ball last time up. And low for ball four. You could almost go and assume, and I really don't know, but that Blackburn may have been intentionally walked, for a lack of a better term. So here is the manager and catcher, Scott Scardina. Out of Rockland, California. He wanted to say hello to his wife, Heidi. Grounded out to third his last time up, but scored the second run when he was a courtesy runner for Dean Mann. That followed the Dean Mann single back in the third inning that gave Sacramento a 2-0 lead. Holland came back with three hits, a walk, reached on an error in Bertram in the fourth inning, and they scored two runs on a two-run single by Marvin Keller. So now Scardina at the plate. Runner at first and one out. 2-2 tie, top of the fifth. Yeah, great night for baseball. I mean, got a chance of rain, obviously, but they... As that one is swung through and missed. That was some high heat. That was a good pitch there by Danny. Two strikes on Scardina. He fouled that one off, out of play. With a runner at first base and one out, top of the fifth. Another two-strike pitch. Breaking ball, caught looking. Strikeout number four, and there's two down. Outstanding pitch, got the benefit of the doubt from our home plate umpire for the called third strike. And now Dean Mann. Called strike 0-1, RBI single back in the third inning. And his courtesy runner came around to score. 2-2 tie here in inning number five. There's a swing and a miss. Nothing and two on Dean Mann. And I would imagine here that Danny's probably going to come back with a breaking ball that's going to be somewhere outside. There it is. They're setting up on the outside part of the plate. Here's the pitch. He came back with the fastball. And it's one ball and two strikes. Trying to get Dean Mann to go fishing. Now we'll see what the strategy here is for Sacramento. Do they come back inside with a breaking ball or go right back out, try to paint the outside corner? Setting up on the outside corner, and it's an off-speed pitch, and Mann has another base hit. That'll put him at first and second, and, well, to be quite honest, that was a pitch that Danny Rossoni would love to have back. He hung that breaking ball and got way too much of the plate, kept it up in the strike zone, and Dean Mann lined it out into right center field for a base hit. That is the fourth hit of the day for Sacramento. And now we go back to the top of the order in Fred Fenton, who comes up empty-handed on the first offering from Rossoni, and it's nothing and one. Fred is grounded to short, and he walked back in the third. Fouled it off, nothing and two. With two out and two on here in the fifth inning. Well, one of the bad things about playing here and playing at the new Cubs Park just down the street at Sloan Field, unfortunately, we are right in the pathway of the airplanes. So there's not much we can do about it. As we try to pick up all the ambient sounds of the game, unfortunately, we pick up the sounds of those jets flying over. It's almost like playing at Old Shea Stadium and LaGuardia Airport just down the street there. Two strikes on this leadoff hitter, Fred Fenton, first batter in the lineup. He's up there with runners at first and second, two out. We're in the top of the fifth, 2-2 tie, and the two-strike pitch. Trying to come back with that backdoor breaking pitch and missed inside. Good idea by Danny Rossoni. Rossoni kicks and dials and struck him out. He just reached back and brought in that nothing but the number one pitch, the big fastball, and they will leave two. We're going to the bottom of the fifth inning. A great job, a gutsy pitching performance by Danny Rossoni as we go to the bottom of the fifth in a 2-2 tie. You're watching the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN Video Sports. We're in the 45-plus Cactus Division of the 2015 MSBL World Series. Holland with two runs in the fourth inning will bat here in the fifth, looking to take their first lead of the contest. Ott van der Londen will be the first batter, an infield hit in the first. He struck out in the third. Dave Blackburn, starting pitcher here today in his fifth inning, and here's a ground ball down to first, and Eric Sex will take it to the bag, out number one. Harry DeVitt is looking for his first hit, the center fielder of the Holland Astros. For this 5:54 start time, starting a little early today. That's a strike on DeVitt. And nothing in two. Longtime friend of Montiano Bloom, the manager, the creator of this team. That's a slider, and a nice job by Harry laying off that pitch, who is married to Melanie, and together they are the proud parents of two children, two sons, Luca and Noah. He's got a good eye at the plate, the 1-2 pitch, but this time he goes down on strikes, and that's out number two. That is the second punch out of the day here for
number 25, Manny Ocampo.
Mr. Blackburn, and now Manny Ocampo at the plate. Manny has hit into a fielder's choice. He has singled. Singled and scored back in the fourth inning. He's 1-for-2. Takes inside for ball one. Two out, nobody on. We're in the fifth. 2-2 tie as the Holland Astros and the Sacramento Bulldogs are on the air. MSBL World Series on APN. Tried to check his swing. It's a called strike, and the count is even. One ball, one strike with Montiano Bloom on deck for the Holland Astros. Blackburn delivers, and the changeup is high. 2-1 on Manny. Longtime manager of the Las Vegas Rattlers. Here's the pitch. And got ate up with that inside fastball. And now the count, two balls, two strikes on Ocampo. The third place hitter in the lineup for the Astros here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Two out, nobody on, and the two-strike pitch. And that one catches the outside corner, and Ocampo not too happy with the call. It looked like it might have been a few inches off the outside part of the plate. Back-to-back strikeouts ends the fifth inning for Blackburn and Sacramento as they come to the plate here in the top of the sixth. 2-2 tie. This is the MSBL World Series on APN Video Sports. Sean Feiser is going to be batting for Tim Rooney to start the top of the sixth inning for Sacramento. So Sean Feiser, good breaking pitch. Sixth inning of work for starting pitcher Danny Rossoni. 50-year-old right-hander has thrown very well. Seems like he's almost gaining some velocity. Strike three called. And out number one, that is his sixth strikeout of the game. They did not announce. This is Ted Peart. So Ted Peart batting for the first time. One out, nobody on, top of the sixth. Fouling off the first pitch out of play. Nothing in one the count. He got jammed on that one and bloops it to the third baseman who cannot make a play on it. And that is, boy, I'll tell you, that's a tough call there. I don't know if he throws him out, so they're going to rule that an infield hit. Fifth base hit of the ball game, and now the batter is going to be Dave Graham. That's low. Runner started to go. Saw that ball get away from the catcher. But it didn't get far enough, and now 2-0 on Graham batting for the first time. So Graham batting for Joe Hoy, the third baseman. And Sacramento trying to play as many of their players as possible. Not a bad-looking pitch, and it's called for a ball, and it's three balls and no strikes here in inning number six. 2-2 tie, runner at first and one out. And get me over called strike 3-1. Big pitch coming up right here. Can't afford to put on any more runners. 2-2 tie. 3-1 breaking ball. That's big league right there. 3-2. That's a big league breaking ball. Now Graham, who was up three balls, no strikes, now finds himself three balls, two strikes. And let's see if Sacramento does a little hit and run here on 3-2. Payoff pitch. And it's lined up the middle and in the center field, a base hit. So back-to-back hits. And now they have changed the base hit to an error by Pert. So they've charged an error to the third baseman, and now you got runners at first and second with one man out. And Sacramento looking to regain the lead. They led 2-0 at the end of 2.5 innings of play. And now Fred Livano. It's kind of interesting. You'll a lot of the managers in this MSBL World Series, they'll add players to the bottom of the order, but kind of we've seen pinch hitters for the heart of the order. That's kind of unusual. What a pitch that time by Danny Rosani. You get the feeling that this home plate umpire has just expanded his strike zone just a little bit, which will definitely benefit the pitchers. That's fouled off to the right side. First baseman over, and he's got it. Fine catch. Nice running catch by Clemens. And the mountain climber went a long ways to make that play. Two down. And this is Fontano, Mario Fontano batting. And he hits one a ton in the right field, caught, inning over. Nice job, and for the, second inning in a row that Danny Rossoni has pitched out of big-time trouble. So we go to the bottom of the sixth inning, and we are still locked in a 2-2 tie. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN Sports. Dave Blackburn in his sixth inning of work delivers the first pitch, ball one, to Montiano Bloom, who is singled in both his plate appearances today. And he's ahead in the count, one ball, no strikes. He scored in the fourth, singled in the first, and he singled in the fourth. Started this team in 2013, and a pop-up that the catcher will not have a play on it, and it's 1-1. And we're proud to say that we've been a part of each of the three seasons that the Holland Astros been in existence, and we like to thank Montiano for allowing us, as this ball's hammered to deep center field, way back, and that ball's going to be caught on the run. Sean Feiser with an outstanding catch, robbing Montiano Bloom of extra bases in straightaway center field, and there's one down for Marvin Keller, who drove in both of the Holland Astros runs in this game back in the fourth inning. He's first pitch hacking, and he lifts one back as shortstop, and that's going to drop in for a hit. So Keller is on for the second time in three tries. Keller will be lifted for a courtesy runner, which is Montiano Bloom. And the batter is going to be Marcel Marswardout, looking for his first hit of the game. The go-ahead run is at first base for the Holland Astros as they bat here in the bottom of the sixth inning in a 2-2 tie. I would imagine Montiano, this might be a good opportunity for this team to get a stolen base. Looking to manufacture runs against one of the tough pitchers in Blackburn, and just right on cue, an easy stolen base for Bloom. Now, if you have speed and you're playing in the 45 and over or the 50 and over, that is a very big weapon in your arsenal. Ground ball, shortstop. Sean Rooney on to first.
Number 22, Greg Bertram.
Good base running there by Bloom. He moves up 90 feet to third base. Here's Greg Bertram. So Dave Blackburn getting set to go up against a man who is 0-for-2, reached on an error in the fourth inning. Slider. Good looking pitch there. Did not give Dave Blackburn the benefit of the doubt. It's one ball and no strikes. Runner at third representing the go-ahead run for Holland. Fastball 2-0. You see Blackburn a little upset, not demonstrative in any stretch of the imagination, but he is certainly could have gotten a strike call on either one of those first two offerings to Bertram. And Greg swings over a breaking pitch, and it's two balls and one strike. Starting shortstop for the Holland Astros. Strike called. Two strikes. An alumni of the University of Arizona. He's a Wildcat. 2-2 pitch. Swung on and fouled off is Bertram. Blackburn sights a sign from his catcher. Runner at third, two out, bottom of the sixth inning, 2-2 tie in the 2-2 pitch. Nice job by the catcher, keeping that ball in front of him. Scott Scardina, the manager of the Sacramento Bulldogs, and a swing and a miss, high heat. It was outside. Four strikeouts for Blackburn as we head to the seventh. And we're still knotted in, a 2-2 tie from Hohokam. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series on APN.
Number 25,
Robert Sexton. Robert Sexton to start it off. I'm sorry. Robert Sexton. Interesting. What threw me there for just a bit, Eric Sex is the seventh place hitter. Sexton is appropriately replacing Sex. 2-2 tie here in the seventh inning. There's a swing and a foul in the seventh inning of work for Danny Rossoni. Italian born, lived a couple of years in England. He has struck out six. He has scattered six, and now he hits Sexton, and the leadoff hitter is aboard. That is the first time in this game Sacramento has had the leadoff hitter aboard in an inning. All right, here's Blackburn, who has tripled and walked in two plate appearances against Rossoni. Breaking ball called strike 0-1. Jeff Lowery with you, APM Video Sports. Our website is apmvideo.com, and it is now trivia time. Our award-winning APN trivia question coming up after this pitch. Blackburn takes a strike and it's 0-2. Eight teams in Major League Baseball history who are still current teams, current franchises, eight franchises who have never won a World Series championship still in existence. Now, I'm not talking about the St. Louis Browns or it has to be an existing team. There is actually eight teams that still have not won a World Series. We'll give you the answer probably in the top of the eighth inning. So get your baseball thinking caps on. Eight teams in existence today that have still not won a World Series. Blackburn skies at the right field. That's an easy play. And that's out number one. So the catch made by Titus Bloom out in right field. Catcher Scott Scardina. And he's down, no balls and one strike. And he's down, nothing and two, and Scott didn't like the call. Slightly open stance, right-handed hitting catcher. Rossoni delivers, and it's outside, 1-2. And you saw Scardina take a long stare at the umpire. He was thinking maybe he was going to get rung up on that last pitch, but it was clearly outside. I think at this point you might have to expand your strike zone a bit if you're a hitter, especially with two strikes. And he had a good cut at a primetime fastball right down the middle and fouled it back. One ball, two strikes on Scardina. That's a tough pitch. And really, that's about all you can do on a pitch like that. Good breaking ball. Probably would have been a called strike on the inside part of the plate. So one and two on the Sacramento catcher in the pitch. And that's inside. He did not go around. And it's two balls, two strikes. Scott looking for his first hit of the ball game. Go ahead, run at first and one out. 2-2 tie in the seventh, and he lifts this one out of play. So he's hanging tough. Two balls, two strikes again. And a chopper to the left side, and gets through for a base hit. Seventh hit of the ball game, and they're at first and second with one out. What a big time at bat by Scott Scardina. He was down nothing and two in the count. He fought off a couple of very, very good pitches by Danny Rossoni and was able to bounce one cleanly through the hole between the shortstop and third baseman for a one-out single. First and second occupied, and here's Dean Mann, who has singled twice in two tries. No balls and one strike. Drove in a run in the third. His courtesy runner came around to score. That's just off the plate, 1-1. Infield at double play depth. One out. Sexton led off the inning. He was hit by a pitch, a fly ball to right field. As it's 2-1 now, the count on Dean Mann. Scardina standing at first base with a one-out single to left field. First and second. Breaking ball, popped him up on the infield. Who wants it? It's going to be the pitcher, and there's two down. He was the only one that could make that play. So with two down in the inning, the batter is going to be the Richard Temple. So Richard Temple batting for the first time. And this might be for Fred Fenton. Now we got helicopters, we got airplanes, we got birds, we got it all here at Hohokam Park. Two on, two out here in the top of the seventh inning. 2-2 tie. Sacramento at the plate. Boy, not a bad pitch, not a bad looking pitch there. Sacramento got two runs in the second inning. RBI hits by Rooney and Mann. Holland came back with two in the fourth. A two-run single to right field by Marvin Keller. Runners are at first and second, two out. And Richard Temple looking to drive in a run here. And he swings and he misses. Going down on strikes and the seventh of the day for Rossoni. Seventh inning stretch time from Hohokam Park in Mesa. 28th annual MSBL World Series on APM will continue in just a moment. Great job by Rossoni. And you talk about this Sacramento team. They keep knocking on the door, but Rossoni just continues to work out of trouble. He has been in big hot water for three consecutive innings and has been able to get out of each of the last three innings unscathed. Dan Clemens will start it off. Scrappy Benko and Titus Bloom, the scheduled hitters behind him. And I say the scheduled hitters because you never know who's going to who these managers will pinch hit. I don't know if, and I really, to be honest with you, I forgot to ask Monty before the game if, you know, if he's going to be adding players to the bottom of the order. As this one is lifted in the air, the second baseman will make the play on the right field side of the bag, and there's one down. Fred Livano now playing second base. One up and one down. And here's Scrappy Benko. Benko is ground into third. He has walked. Bottom of the seventh inning, 2-2 tie. Holland at the plate. Nothing in one, the count on Benko. And a lot of cheerleaders here today. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-2. Both pitchers have given up two earned runs. Both pitchers have given up seven hits. Blackburn has struck out four and make it five as he takes care of Benko on three pitches. Two down. I think we are going to get a different, let's see, is Titus is going to be lifted for a pinch hitter, and this is Stuart Sallow out of Boulder, Colorado. Owns a newspaper up there, originally from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Wife Mary and a 15-year-old daughter, Maya. And he's ahead in the count, one ball and no strikes. Big-time Minnesota Twins fan, Harmon Killebrew fan. Wrote a touching tribute to Harmon Killebrew, who actually I think lived here in the Valley of the Sun. Just passed away not too long ago, I'd say in the last two years. One of the great home run hitters, the Hall of Famer, Harmon Killebrew. And Stuart wrote a really nice tribute to him. And the newspaper back in Denver, which he owns. A very youthful 60-year-old right-handed hitter. And a ground ball to the shortstop. They got to hurry. Throw on to first in time. And that'll retire the side here in the seventh. We're heading to the eighth inning. A trivia question answer will be coming up next. It's the 28th annual MSBL World Series, Sacramento and Holland in a 2-2 tie. Jeff Lowery coming to you from Hohokam Park. We're in Mesa. 2-2 tie, Sacramento batting for the eighth time. Top of the eighth inning. Well, we're seeing just about everybody in the lineup here as Miguel White, first pitch hitting, drives one to center field. And a good effort by DeVitt, and White with outstanding speed has a leadoff three-base hit, the second triple of the day for the Bulldogs, and they're off and running here in the top of the eighth inning. Next batter is going to be Sean Feiser. First pitch inside, ball one. Feiser, a strikeout victim back in the sixth inning. Swing and a miss. Boy, he had a healthy cut at that pitch. Danny Rossoni has given up two runs, eight hits. He has struck out seven. Here's a ball past the third baseman in the left field. And Sacramento, for the second time today, has the lead. Feiser comes through with an RBI single here in the eighth, and they lead it 3-2. Next batter is going to be Ted Peart. Outside ball one to Peart. Ted reached on an error in the sixth inning. So the pitchers of record as of right now, with Sacramento leading it by a score of 3-2, would be Danny Rossoni, would be, unfortunately for the Holland Astros, the losing pitcher, and Dave Blackburn right now stands to be the winner. We got a lot of baseball left here, top of the eighth inning. Not sure why Peart is so animated after that last pitch. It was called a ball. That's ball four. Well, maybe he wants to hit. You come off the bench and, you know, you don't want to walk. You want to get on base. You want to get a hit. And I think when he went up three balls and no strikes, that he was a little disappointed that there was a good chance he was going to be walked in this game. So after Montiano Bloom meets with his starting pitcher, Livano at the plate, popped up to the first baseman, his first and only time up. Actually, this is Dave Graham. Graham singled back in the sixth. So nine hits in total for the Sacramento Bulldogs, who lead it after an RBI single by Feiser, scoring White from third on a base hit to left field, and Sacramento leads Holland 3-2. And here's the bunt. It's a beautiful one. And they're not going to have a play anywhere. That's a bunt single. The bases are loaded, and they are full of Sacramento Bulldogs on a great bunt single. Graham is 2-for-2, and now Livano. And he lines one out into right field, a slicing base hit. Bloom up with it. He will throw to the plate. A powerful throw, holds the runner at third, but it's 4-2. And the bases remain loaded as Livano comes through with a big RBI single. And now the batter is going to be, let's see, this is not Robert Sexton. This is going to be number three, Mario Fontano. So they're staying in the same order. Bases loaded. And nobody out. Called strike on the left-handed hitter. So two runs have scored here for Sacramento in the top of the eighth inning, and they lead it by a score of 4-2. Their second lead of the contest. In the air, and this is a huge out for Holland. A big, big first out. So taken care of by the third baseman. And now the batter is going to be Robert Sexton. Robert was hit by a pitch back in the seventh inning. Slider down and in, ball one. One out, bases loaded, two runs in. Sacramento here in the top of the eighth leads at 4-2. Our trivia question, eight current teams who have never won a World Series championship. Called strike. Sexton probably didn't care for that call. And a lot of backward glances at our home plate umpire here tonight, which is typical of any baseball game. All in all, I think he's done a pretty good job here tonight. And that ball, I think, hit the batter, and he's heading down to first. Are they going to grant him that? No, they are. They will. They're going to send him down to first base. That's an RBI. And just like that, it is now 5-2. 5-2 Sacramento, and the evening is done. Danny Rossoni pitched one whale of a ball game. Can't take anything away from him. He goes 7 1/3 inning, and now we'll give way to the new pitcher, and this is Ken Dalimolli. So Dalimolli, the new pitcher, as we have a break in the action. Dalimolli out of Denver, Colorado. And the first pitch is low for ball one. This is Dave Blackburn. Well, I'll tell you what, this has been a very, very good inning here for this Sacramento team. Dalimolli, 48 years old. He was born in San Jose, California, but has lived in Colorado for the past 20 years. Three kids. And apparently he had a DNA test to see if these kids are really his. That's foul. Soccer, basketball, and ultimate frisbee are their current sports of choice, and Ken remains in therapy trying to understand what he did wrong as a father to have their choices turn out so badly. And by the way, the DNA test came back positive. His number 35 uniform number, he took it in honor of Ricky Henderson, as he has walked the first batter to face here in the eighth inning, and another run is in, and it's 6-2. The bases remain loaded. Teammate with Rick Fisher back in the Denver area. Here's a chopper up along the third baseline, but that's a foul ball. This is Scardina, the starting catcher, who had a base hit back in the seventh inning and is 1-for-3. He pops it up. This is in the shallow, medium depth center field. Might be deep enough to score the run, and it will. The throw will come in to Bloom at shortstop. And, boy, the wheels have come off the hinges here. 7-2 on a sac fly by Scardina to center field. Here's Dean Mann, who has a couple of hits, 2-for-3, including an RBI single back in inning number 3. Drove in the game's first run. So a 5-run eighth makes it 7-2 in favor of Sacramento here in the eighth inning. So the trivia question, the 8 existing teams in Major League Baseball who have never won a World Series, and you got to start with the Astros, the Houston Astros, San Diego Padres, Colorado Rockies, Texas Rangers, Tampa Bay Rays, a couple of teams that have never played in a World Series, let alone win one, Seattle. There's 6 of them. And you can hear the raindrops falling on our camera equipment here at Hohokam Park in Mesa. And Mann hits a fly ball, right field, but foul. Well, that would have probably drove in a lot of runs on that play. 2 down here in the inning. First and third. And here's a chopper towards a shortstop. He'll charge. He will throw to first. He'll throw low. Scooped out nicely by Clemens. And the side is retired. But they come up with 5 big runs. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. It's 7-2 now, Sacramento. This is the 28th annual MSBL World Series. This is APN Video Sports. Well, the Holland Astros have their work cut out for them. They give up 5 runs in the top of the eighth inning, and now here in the bottom of the eighth inning, they'll set their sights on Dave Blackburn in inning number 8, the starting pitcher. Sean Coleman batting for the first time out of Frankfurt, Germany. Played for the Houston A's and Ronnie Stiegel for many years. And competing here in the 45 and over Cactus Division and the Holland Astros. Unless can come up with at least 5 runs before the end of the game as he gets jammed on this one, rolls it out to second, 1 down. Ivano at second base makes the play for Sacramento. That's going to bring up Dave Kirby out of Turlock, California. He was a high school baseball player and an academic All-American, played at Merced College. So Kirby batting for the first time, bottom of the eighth inning. Holland grave danger of dropping to 1-3. As both these teams are playing their fourth game through the first 2 days of their MSBL World Series experience. Kirby swings and misses and quickly goes down on strikes. 2 down here in the inning. And the batter is going to be Manny Ocampo. So Coleman grounds out. Kirby strikes out. Apparently they were inserted into the first and second spots in the order. I thought maybe they were added to the bottom. Ground ball shortstop as Ocampo Goes after the first pitch, and what an easy inning for Dave Blackburn, who has went 8 innings and given up just 2 earned runs. We go to the 9th, and the Holland Astros and the Sacramento Bulldogs competing here in this 2015 MSBL World Series. It's 7-2 Sacramento. Coming to you from the winter home of the Oakland Athletics. And here's a looping fly ball to left field, base hit. The first batter up, Temple, drives a single out into left field. And he is aboard to start the top of the 9th inning. And here's the man who started that 5-run 8th inning with a leadoff triple to right center field. And Miguel White, listed as a second baseman. He tripled and scored to give Sacramento a 3-2 lead. That would be the first of 5 runs in that inning. Top of the 9th inning, 7-2 Sacramento as they bat. They're in the red tops, white pants. White didn't like the last call. 1-1. All right, the answer again to that trivia question, the 8 teams. So we got Houston, San Diego, Colorado, Tampa Bay, and Texas. The Milwaukee Brewers have yet to win a World Series. Now, the Milwaukee Braves with Hank Aaron and Eddie Matthews did, but not as the Brewers. And then two teams that have not only not won a World Championship on this list, but have never been to a World Series. I gave you one earlier as Dolly Molly in his second inning of work, the Seattle Mariners, and the last team, the Montreal Expos / Washington Nationals. Here's a comebacker. This will be a challenging play with the speed of White, but Dolly Molly makes the play with ease, and there's one down. Runner at second base. One out in the inning, and here is the man who added the RBI single to left field, scoring White from third base with the go-ahead run. And Feiser grounds one up the middle and in the center field, a base hit. Coming around third and scoring the 8th run of the ball game is Temple. And what about Feiser? His second RBI single in 3 at bats. And here in the 9th inning, Sacramento leads it 8-2. That'll bring up Peart. Peart walked and came around to score in the 8th inning. So he's walked, he's reached on an error, and is hoping that he can put the bat on the ball here. Ken Dolly Molly in his second inning of work. Well, the pitchers of record, Dave Blackburn with a minimum of a six-run lead going into the bottom of the 9th inning. Be interesting to see if he's going to try to finish what he started. He would be the winning pitcher, and for the Holland Astros, Danny Rossoni will suffer the loss unless Holland can hold him at bay and come up with 6 runs in the bottom of the 9th inning. So you got a runner at first, a run in. Top of the 9th inning, it's 8-2 Sacramento. And another walk for Peart. So they will not pitch to him. First and second now occupied, and Graham is a perfect 2-for-2 at the plate. Couple of players that we really hadn't seen in this game for Holland. Rick Fisher, a Vietnam veteran, 63-year-old. And Roland McKielsen, the third base coach, who gave up his playing time to help coach the team and help with matters and has been a valuable member of this Holland Astros team, Roland McKielsen and his wife, Karen, one of the big cheerleaders. I'm sure you've heard her in the background here at Hohokam Park rooting on this Holland Astros team. So Graham at the plate, 2-for-2. Dolly Molly, he's trying to shake off some of the tingles in his right hand. which anyone who's ever played this game has experienced. He's run the count full on Graham. Graham singled in the sixth. Singled in a run in the eighth inning. And hits a fly ball to left field. And the catch is made by the left fielder, two down. I believe that's Montiano out there. Now Lovano, who had a big RBI hit in that five-run eighth inning, a shot to right field, a good piece of hitting. Up there in an RBI opportunity for the second time. A bad-looking pitch there. Dolly Molly wanted the call. It was a little outside. Still a good location. I think with Lovano's stance and the ability to go the opposite way, you want to pitch him a little more inside. That may be just a tad too much inside. As we play here in the ninth inning, there's a swing and a foul. 8-2 is the score. Sacramento batting. They got a couple of runners on and two out. And a roller towards the shortstop. He will go to second one. And we go to the bottom of the ninth inning. They get another run. They lead 8-2. We go to the bottom of the ninth. Sacramento, they lead by six. The 28th annual MSBL World Series. We go to the bottom of the ninth inning. It will be the heart of the Holland Astro team. It's going to be Montiano Bloom to start things off. Marvin Keller, who had the two-run single back in the fourth to drive in both runs for the Astros, and Marcel Marswardout. Here's a ground ball right side. Nice play by Lovano, and he throws him out at first base, one down. So Dave Blackburn, 8 1/3 inning, and he has pitched a masterpiece. Here's a chopper on the first pitch, another opportunity for the shortstop, and the throw on, two down. Well, it all comes down to Marcel Swartout, starting third baseman for the Holland Astros. Swartout looking for his first hit of the contest. Blackburn winds, kicks, and fires, and it's low and away, ball one. Stay with us. At the conclusion of this game, we will have post-game interviews. We'll try to corral some of the players for the Bulldogs. If not, we'll definitely be talking to today's starting pitcher, Danny Rossani. Swing and a miss. Boy, that's a tough slider, and Blackburn has pitched a dominant game here today. He has struck out six, and another strike. Two strikes on Swartout. He has struck out six. He has scattered seven hits, but he has not given up a hit since the sixth inning. And now the two-strike pitch, and he struck him out swinging. And the ball game is over on the seventh strikeout of the game by Dave Blackburn. And what a way to finish it, setting down the last 11 batters that he faced. He gets the win as the Bulldogs capture their first win in round robin play. They are now 1-3 by way of record. Holland drops to the same record of 1-3. 8-2 is our final score. Stay with us. We'll have our post-game coverage coming up here in a moment on APN Video Sports from Hohokam Park in Mesa.
My name is Danny Rossoni. I'm from Holland, originally Italian. I played baseball for 30 years or so, and I didn't play for, I think, 5 years. So this is also my first time in the States, and it's amazing for me. The experience is unbelievable. First time in a light game, first time in Major League ballpark, first time in the States. And yeah, maybe you couldn't see it, but for me the first two innings were pretty emotional. So I don't know what you want further.
That's good.
I don't know, I'm not a lot about, because I was too young when I left Italy. The first time I came in contact with baseball was in 1986. I saw a poster of baseball. I didn't know what it was, what kind of sport it was. I saw a ball flying, I saw a bat swinging, and I liked it immediately. So I fetched the book, I read it, and then I tried to find a club near us. And 500 meters from my home, there was a baseball club. So I started when I was, I think, 12, 13. And from there on, the highest level in Holland. I reached that. Okay, I'll try it again. Okay. I reached the top level in Holland for 1 year. And then, I didn't go any further because I didn't want to travel anymore and to train a little bit less. So I played a little bit lower. And yeah, still, I'm 50 and baseball is still my sport number one. And it always will be.
Yes, hi, Brian Benko from Denver. I'm amazed at these guys. It's been just awesome being on the same team with them. They're great guys. I'm awestruck by them. They're competitors, and I can't say enough about the Holland guys.
Hi, my name's Manny Ocampo from Las Vegas, and this is the third year that I played with the Holland Astros, and it's just a great time. We get together, have lunches, dinners. We're out here to play baseball and compete, but it's important for us to have a good time too, so that's why I come out. Monty used to play with me with my Las Vegas Rattlers, and that's how I met him years ago. And when I stopped managing and he moved back to Holland, he put together the Holland team and invited me out to play. So I keep coming back. Eventually we're going to have to move up in age because, we're all getting older and it's getting tougher. But this is second doubleheader. We had a doubleheader today, doubleheader yesterday, and we've got two more games in pool play. We just got to suck it up and keep battling. We'll win the next two games.
Okay, my name is Roland Machielsen, and yeah, it's the second time that I'm over here. Last year also with Holland Astros, and yeah, it's nice to play at this kind of field and enjoying the game that I love. I'm here with my wife for the second time, and I hope to go next year with my son, father and son, and then afterwards again over here. So, and it's fun with the team, that is a mixed team of Dutch guys, and yeah, you already saw it on the video, Denver and Vegas, and it's a bunch of sweet guys, and we had a lot of fun, so that's important. That's the main game. Yes.
Playing with Moniano coming out of Houston, that's how we got to know him several years ago, and obviously having a passion for baseball and these Dutch guys he's brought over. I can't say enough about him. Had great time with him every year. It's third year now. These guys are good friends. It's been a lot more than just baseball. The Denver guys have now joined us, and then Manny from Las Vegas. So we've got quite a group here, and had a great time with them.
Okay, I'm Marcel Zwartau. I'm from the Netherlands. I'm born in Rotterdam, and I'm 50 years old. This is my third year over here. And I think we have now our best team ever. So if we get a bit more luck with the hits, we will sure get to the playoffs. And I think we earn it, because we are a great team. We have a lot of experience, a lot of young guys. And they are really enthusiastic. So I think it's a really fun tournament. And we hope to get to the playoffs. We will. And then we get to the final as well. So. Thank you.
Okay, this is my 10th time out here playing this great tournament, and every time it's with a great group of guys. And like we fought today, I'm really proud of everybody on the team, how we kept fighting and kept grinding. We came short a little bit, but the whole week is a big success. And I just want to finish with number 21, you're with us. Thank you.